is what he loves. I keep trying to conceive that death is from above.
No time.
I get mine and make no excuses. Waste of precious breath.
No time.
The sun shines on everyone. Everyone, love yourself to death.
So you gotta fire up.
You think it'd be? Turn your head for 1 second and the tables turn. Yeah. And I know that I did you wrong. Will you trust me when I say that I'll make it up to you somehow?
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Greetings, NBA fans. Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson, and seated beside me, Kenny the Jet Smith and the Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. And tonight, it'll be the Houston Rockets going up against the Mavericks in Dallas. For Dallas, what a year they're having. They've run up the best record in the NBA with some absolutely flawless performances. They've been a fun team to watch over the first half of the season. Houston is a team that can put up numbers in a hurry, no question about that. But with the amount of three-pointers they take, Kenny, do they really, I guess, rely too much on the long ball?
Well, some could say that because, you know, 40% of their shots that they make come from three-point land. That's an incredible amount when you have a guy like Dwight Howard in the post and you have guys in the post that like to score. So they might be a little three-heavy, though.
No, not might. They are three-heavy. They need to understand inside-out wins championship, especially there in Houston. They took a lot of threes, but they were not great. They only shot 35% last year. They need to get the ball inside.
Tip-off is coming up shortly. We go courtside right now to Kevin Harlan.
The Rockets are looking to defeat their Western Conference rival going into this game. And as we start the weekend here on this Friday night, 2K Sports welcoming you to NBA basketball. I'm Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony and Doris Burke reporting from the sidelines. Take a look at the Mavericks. Still early in the season, but the front office and coaching staff likes what they are seeing from this team so far. Better winning percentage than last year.
You know, right now, Dallas, they have performed above and beyond expectations thus far. As good as they've been, is it fair to wonder just how long they can keep this up?
Of course it is. I mean, I'll tell you this. They may have snuck up on some of their opponents here in the early season, but they're not sneaking up on anybody anymore. Teams will be ready for them.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So on the floor for Houston, Harden and Ariza filling out the perimeter. Howard is out there with Beasley, and it's Beverly in at the point. Last season for James Harden was easily his best yet. Finished second in the MVP race. Put up huge numbers with career highs in points per game scoring. Greg at more than 27 a game.
And also carries that Rockets team that dealt with a plethora of injuries, mainly to Dwight Howard. And second in the league in scoring, I mean, narrowly losing out to Russell Westbrook, who just went on a tremendous tear second half of the season. And then also finished runner-up in the MVP race.
For Houston, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Over in the corner, Beverly from downtown. It's rebounded by Dallas. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
Yeah, not a very inspired performance for them, particularly when they were defending. They just gave that hostile crowd plenty to cheer for.
Yeah, they allowed a lot of free runs to the hoop, a lot of open jump shots, and in the end, the opponent's shooting percentage was through the roof. You can't win if your defense isn't better than that.
Here's Beasley, the Mavericks making the shot. Screened by Howard. Beasley, the pass to Beverly. Nails the wide-open jump shot. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Outside Matthews. Now the feed to Pachulia. Excellent D there from Beasley.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, Greg, making every shot a hard one, even the shots in close.
They get it back, Harden. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, free throws are always better than a layup, so I'd agree with you there, Greg.
Harden hits them both.
Just call him the beard. James Harden, not just iconic, but also entering the conversation for the best player in the NBA.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes, like conducting an orchestra.
Inside, here's Beasley. Soft touch off the glass. Beasley's got his second bucket of the night.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
And speaking of Harden and being the best, he'd certainly tell you so. He referred to himself as the best all-around player in the league. What do you think?
And I think he's right in that category. A lot of people laughed him off when he said that, but he's been a legitimate MVP candidate. His defense has gotten better, and obviously his offensive game is off the charts.
And the second free throw, good.
And Chandler Parsons, boy, he can really give you a whole lot of everything. Length, quickness, skills, can shoot, pass, rebound, defend, the total package.
Now here's Beverly. 8 points his last outing. Howard gets to a reason. Beverly wide open. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Beverly's got 5 now.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
And back to Chandler Parsons. His versatility is so valuable to any scheme. We've now seen that in both Houston and Dallas. He gives you percentages and good production every time out.
He does, Kevin, but the one area where I'd like to see him improve is his physical strength. I mean, to take his game to the next level, he's got to be able to play through contact a little bit better. If he can do that, we're talking about a guy who could be a perennial all-star.
Can't get it to go. Good D by Ariza. Here's Beasley. It's rebounded by Dallas. Pachulia's got his 3rd rebound on the night. And finished off by Parsons.
That's a quick bucket there. Solid in transition.
Well, you know, he loves the chance to get out and run, and we could see right there why he does.
Williams against Beverly, and it's Ariza in the corner. Jacks up a 3. Matthews with the rebound.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
Parsons using his post move to get the 2 points. Parsons got 5.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Out of bounds, Dallas takes possession.
All right, a chance to check out the stats for Matthews. His last 10 games have been exceptional. He's putting up 31 points per, 8 assists, and 5 rebounds. And he's a threat to go off in any game from anywhere.
Some guys just have the gift, and he's one of them. You need points, he's your go-to guy. Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
Ariza with the bucket.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
For Dallas, they've gone 7 of 11 from the field to begin the game. And Parsons kicks to Nowitzki. A 3-pointer off the mark. Houston's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Harden dishes to Howard. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. And Chandler Parsons really set off a Texas rivalry last year, drafted by the Rockets in the second round. He received an offer sheet in free agency from the team's rival, the Dallas Mavericks, eventually chose Dallas, injured in the playoffs, hurt a knee, only played the one game. But I think they've got great things ahead for him with the Mavs.
Yeah, you know, Parsons was a restricted free agent, so that meant the Rockets could match if they wanted to, but they declined to match Dallas's offer, which sent Parsons packing just up the road in Texas.
That was some slick passing from Harden on that one.
Mavericks trail by three. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Yes, Kevin, I was able to catch up with the head coach for the Rockets just a moment ago. I asked him about the difficulty defensively against a team that's so smart and controlled offensively. He said that's a great point. They really do a terrific job of executing their offense. Not a lot of miscues or missteps. We need to be just as disciplined if we're going to get the upper hand. And down 1-0 in the season series, guys, we'll see if they can even it up.
Great stuff, Doris. Thanks. It sounds like the most important number for them today is opposing shooting percentage.
As it should be. I mean, this is an opponent that can go through some very hot stretches with the ball. So they've got to do what they can to limit those opportunities.
Yeah, and for what Coach was saying, guys, I mean, he knows that. They should play some suffocating D today if he got his message across.
And it's Beverly missing.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
And Nowitzki gets it to go down on the assist by Pachulia. Nowitzki's got his second bucket. The Rockets were terrific on the road last season, Clark. Tied for second with the Clippers for the most road wins in the league.
26-15, although if you want to get picky about it, they had one of those wins in Mexico City, so maybe 25.5 road wins for them.
And Houston calls their first time out of the game.
And I do remember that Mexico City game last year for the Rockets. A huge turnout for them. It felt like they were the crowd favorites. Still, you can't take anything away from their road performances last season.
J.J. Barea has checked in for Pachulia. The Rockets trail. Now Beverly. He has five. Beasley the screen. Here's Ariza. Sweet little floater. Ariza's got 9 points.
And, you know, you think about the Rockets, as you mentioned. I mean, one reason they were so good on the road is their offense didn't miss a beat when they left Houston. When you can get to the line as much as they did, you remain consistent on the road.
Now Beverly, following the three-point attempt by Wesley Matthews. Great open look there. And it's a four-point Rocket lead.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
In the corner, Harden. No good on the three. Dallas has gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Houston's gone 4-7 from three-point range so far in the first. There's the bucket. Good. Harden's got seven.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Matthews. Good D by Ariza.
Man, that is a missed opportunity right there.
And he'll be the first to tell you, Greg, that's one he should have knocked down.
Howard gets to Ariza. That's good. And so Howard with the assist.
For three.
And that's 15 points for Trevor Ariza.
It just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Back to Parsons. Lets it fly. Misses off the left iron. On offense, here are the Rockets. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. Ariza with it. Picked up by Nowitzki. It's Harden with the drive. Here's Beasley. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Assisted.
Beasley's got six.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end. He's having quite the quarter here, guys. I mean, shooting the ball extremely well.
There's the pick. Kicks it to Harden. The shot from 20 feet away. Leaps for it, and the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Harden. And there before you are the teams that have been absolutely red hot for the last 10 games. The Mavericks, number one.
You have to be impressed with their shot selection. I mean, the discipline on that end and the unselfishness really is what allows those great numbers to show up.
And Matthews kicks to Nowitzki. Got that one up quick. And now just a 5-point Rocket lead.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. A master at it.
You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
Now a timeout called by Houston. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
The thing I took away from that game was just how dominant they were on the backboard.
Well, it would have been hard not to see how dominant they were based on the numbers. I mean, they just completely dominated the glass.
Powell, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Felton comes in for Jaren Williams. Rejected by Nowitzki. Now the Mavericks moving it up. Felton leading the charge. And Barea with the basket on the assist by Felton. Barea's got his first points of the night. Houston leading by three. Pass to Beverly. From past the arc. And the rebound goes to Nowitzki.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
And it's Capella missing. Here's Dallas. It's been 8 unanswered points for him. Matthews, that's good, and so Felton has the assist there. 10 points for Wesley Matthews.
And last year, we saw Coach Rick Carlisle pass the 600 win mark. Former Coach of the Year award winner, has had so much success here in Dallas. One of many coaches to play for the 80s Celtics.
Pushing it up, it's deflected. Count the bucket. Matthews has got 12 in the game.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
Now, here's Beverly. He's got 5. They double him with Matthews. Harden with it. Now Felton defending. And he gets it to go.
You know, the defense was lax right there, and he's able to make them pay.
Dallas has gone 2-of-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Here's Powell, and another basket for Dallas.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The last 5 trips they've had have ended with a great pass leading to a basket. They're really sharing the sugar.
Now here's Ariza. 11 points for him in that last game against New Orleans.
Yeah, and talk about his scoring. I mean, Kevin, with the defense trying to pressure him, he did a good job of getting them to overcommit and getting himself to the line.
The Mavericks making a change here. Chalmers has checked in. And a switch here also for Houston. Goudlock has checked in. And for Raymond Felton last year was nothing short of a disaster. Missed the first 31 games with an ankle injury sustained in preseason. And he played for a poor team. And things, you know, Greg, being the lead of the ball handler like you were, they just never got much better for Felton as the season went on.
Yeah, the problem when you have that issue early on, the season isn't going to wait for him.
Right.
You know, you're basically in catch-up mode, and so because of that, he never got into any kind of a rhythm when he was available to play. And that's not surprising, given that he averaged less than 10 minutes a game for the season after averaging 33 a game for his entire career. Now, this is just getting ridiculous. They can't possibly keep this up.
Can't remember the last time they missed one. Remarkable shooting here.
The Rockets with another miss. The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Mavericks ahead as they end the first quarter on a 20-3 run. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
HBK, yeah, you know how we.
and Dwight Howard, a lightning rod figure around the league, subject to a lot of criticism, but he says he takes comfort in playing the game he still loves.
Basketball, this is my passion. You know, on the court, it's my sanctuary. You know, I want to have fun. The reason I play is to win championships. And I take this game very serious.
It's an interesting concept that Dwight has to take something very seriously in order to have fun. He does say he has a burning passion to win a championship. He's been in the finals, and this is a guy that's got still a lot to shoot for, he feels, in his career.
That's a great point, Kevin. And the challenge for Dwight is how to balance how serious he is and how passionate he is with having that fun on the court that he's after.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And let's take a moment, guys, to get your take on the scoring so far for the Mavericks.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And also, how about the fact defensively they're getting that backboard and getting out in transition, especially in this first half.
We've got Chandler Parsons. Powell is out there with Pachulia. Then there's Chalmers. Then it's Felton in at the two guard. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. Here's Jones. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so strong in the paint.
Pachulia, no luck. Rockets trail by four. Down to lock, passes to Harden. Kicks it out to Jones. They grab their own miss. Smith, and that one is hammered home.
And that's an example of willpower right there, guys. I mean, grabbing the offensive rebound and then going back up strong.
And GA, in a close game like this where every possession is critical, that could prove to be a very big one.
Boy, it sure could, Kevin. I mean, he salvaged two big points for them off that miss.
Here's Gundelach, following the basket by Raymond Felton. Puts it up from seven, and it's blocked. It's Parsons running. He can go all the way, and he gets the bucket. And it's 8 points for Raymond Felton.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assist. That's very impressive, and it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
And it falls over the rim and in. That's 12 points for Beasley.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
Can't hit, and it's Houston the other way. Last time they met in Houston.
You know what? A lot of three-pointers, but for me, more so, it was the shot selection on those three-pointers. I just felt like they were just too trigger-happy from downtown.
You know, Greg, sometimes you're able to shoot your way out of a slump, but they just kept making things worse. Sometimes the harder you try, the worse it gets. No tip required when you've got room to make the stuff.
Has some powerful second chance points right there.
Yeah, the guy's not wasting any time. Just straight back up with it.
Dallas again missing. Rockets have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5 for 9.
You know, you look at Dallas, and that team didn't rely too much on the mid-range or the short game last season, but they could have. They shot 70% from 12 feet and in, excluding drives. That's pretty good.
Parsons on the wing. The shot drops. His shooting percentage improves. He's 3 for 7 now with that basket. It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
No kidding. I mean, neither team has been able to hold the lead for any length of time, guys.
So close.
Exactly, guys. The way it's seesawed back and forth, unbelievable.
Now, here is Harden. He's coming off a 19-point game against New Orleans.
And don't forget about his work on the glass. I mean, he contributed in a number of ways.
For the Mavs, and that 70% shooting from 12 feet and in, a lot of Dirk high posts and push shots from their guards will do that.
It isn't the most efficient shot by analytics, but there is a lot to be had in the mid-range. If teams only protect the three and the rim, you can feast on them with the little short push shots. And the Mavs did that last season.
Well, looking back on last season, you didn't know where the Rockets would end up in terms of seeding in the playoffs. Okay. Ended up with the 2 seed because they won the Southwest Division. And as it turned out, everything worked out very well for them.
It really did. And had a divisional matchup in that first round against the Mavs. But the Rockets took care of business in that series and would advance.
Looking at who's out there now for the Mavericks. Williams comes in for Raymond Felton. And Barea subbed in for Mario Chalmers. And then for Houston, Howard's checked in for Jones, and it's Patrick Beverley in for James Harden. And it's sent back by Howard.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
And guys, right now, the defense mentally not there. Can't afford too many of those in a close game like this.
Yeah, Jay, you're right. Almost a free run, don't you think? Clark to the hoop for him there.
Momentum can swing on plays like that, Kevin, especially when the finish has that much thunder on it. And, you know, for the Rockets, they had a major gut check in the second round. Went down 3-1 against the Clippers. Came back to win the series in 7, including game 6, when I dozed off when they were trailing by 19 in the 4th. And was shocked to wake up in the morning and see they had forced the 7th game.
Beverley with the ball. 5 points in the game. Guard block. That's good. And the Rockets lead by 3.
That's the 3rd bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle much more effectively.
You just cannot allow the offense to have that quality of a look each and every possession. And with the Rockets' last postseason, their trip to the conference finals was as far as they would go. Went out to the Warriors in 5 games. Most of them, though, close ones. I think most fans were pleased with how far the team went last year in spite of all the injuries.
And stolen by Howard. Here's Beasley. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Beasley's got 16 points. And a look at how the hustle game has been going for Houston.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steals.
And also, how about the fact defensively they're getting that backboard and getting out in transition, especially in this first half.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game.
And guys, Patrick Beverley, a perfect fit for the Rockets alongside James Harden. You know, Beverley is in that complementary role as a 3-and-D guy. And remember, also, even though he's the point guard, he doesn't need the ball to be effective. He's good at just spotting up for threes, and he's a hounding on-ball defender.
Dirk Nowitzki, he's checked in for Dallas. And then for Houston, Mateunis comes in for Josh Smith. And Trevor Ariza has subbed in for Michael Beasley. And Barea has it in the corner. And the shot falls short this time. And Beverley plucked out of Europe by the Rockets. Clark, he signed a new contract this past offseason.
And a nice value for the Rockets, Kevin. I mean, he's a player whose impact on the game really transcends the stat sheet. That's often the case for those guys that are all defense caliber players.
Pachulia, no luck.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Howard rejected by Nowitzki. Now here's Barea, defended by Beverley. To the middle, here's Howard. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And guys, you know, we've talked about it before, but it bears repeating. Dwight Howard may be the best overall rebounder in the last decade. 5 times out of the last 8 years, he's led the league in rebounding. That's almost impossible to do in the modern NBA.
Matthews, he's checked in for Pachulia. Howard is still, Clark, an efficient rebounder, still prolific, in fact, but he's no longer dominant. Last year, he had not 1 20-plus rebound game. Tell me the last time that happened.
Well, you know, this being Dwight's 12th season in the league, Kevin, a lot of wear and tear on him. I think he's trying to fight through it, and he's still very much more than serviceable. Wants to get a ring, and he's doing his part to try to make that happen.
Here's Beverley. Darren Williams picking up that last basket, and that's a foul called on J.J. Barea. That's his first foul. The Rockets making a switch here. Capella's checked in. And the Rockets with possession here. Now here's Beverly. He's got five. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. And continuing to expand his arsenal last season, Patrick Beverly, the guard for the Rockets. Career highs in assists and rebounds per game, and he's one of the smallest guys on the floor.
Yeah, and he's really working on the details of becoming a better playmaker, becoming a guy that has coaches trust him to handle the basketball in those crucial situations.
Now here's Williams. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Portland.
But his passing just blew me away. I mean, to see him operate their offense that way was a breath of fresh air.
Beverly against Parsons, and it's sent back by Nowitzki. And now Matthews pushing it up. No one back to stop him.
And one area where they haven't struggled has been transition.
Yeah, I think that may be their ticket out of the hole. Look for even more of those quick hitters.
Here's Beverly, 7 points in the game.
You know, talking about Beverly, his wrist injury really changed things for the Rockets at the end of last season. Suddenly, 37-year-old Jason Terry had to take on big minutes at the point, and he was serviceable, but they missed Beverly's toughness on defense particularly. Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Yeah, they have really owned the interior. You've got to collapse that defense and force them to beat you over the top.
Dallas calls timeout.
And going back to the one thing with Patrick Beverly, his shot could still be more consistent. Last year, he was down in shooting averages across the board, including just 38% from the field. It makes it very difficult on your offense when you have an inability to space the floor.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
And we've seen Dallas just be fantastic since the start of the new millennium. Year in and year out, they seem to always win 50 games. Hit that mark again last season.
Rockets leading by 7. He kicks it to Capella. The dish now to Gaudelot. Ariza has the open look. And again, it's the Rockets from deep. Well, last season they won 50, Greg, as you just said. That marked Clark the 12th time. It happened since 2000.
Well, clearly this franchise has been committed to winning. I mean, you hear that from a lot of franchises, but they often aren't willing to take the risk that the Mavericks take. And the Mavs do a good job of putting their money where their mouth is.
And so it's Houston with it, following the score by Dallas.
All right, a chance to check out the stats for J.J. Barea. His last 10 games, he's averaging 8 points, 8 assists and 2 rebounds. And his playmaking really stands out, making his teammates better offensively with his terrific passing.
Yeah, he's outstanding at controlling the tempo. I mean, keeps the ball moving and, of course, finds the open man.
Here's Beverly following the score by Dallas. Lock at 6. Beyond the arc.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had early.
Matthews into the lane. Second shot opportunity, and Nowitzki puts it in. Nowitzki's got 10 points.
Now that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
And here's Beverly. He has 7, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
You know, they've changed their game here in the second. Getting a little bit more physical, playing with some toughness now.
And I'm looking for them to increase that lead if they can keep getting to the free throw line.
James Harden, he's checked in for the Rockets. The big change last year for the Mavs came when they traded for Rajon Rondo. It looked to be the missing piece for him, Clark, but boy, it just never seemed to come together.
You just don't know. Trades are always risky. You don't know how they're going to work out. And I give credit to ownership for talking to the players to see what they thought about the trade before they actually made the deal.
And that one's good. And 12 points for Dirk Nowitzki. 1:56 left to play here in the second quarter. To the paint. Here's Monty Unis. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got his 8th assist here tonight.
He's making it look easy scoring out there because he's much more efficient here in the second.
It'll go. The Rocket lead is cut to just 7 on the basket from Nowitzki.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
And trailing in this game, now is not the time to start playing conservatively. I mean, if you've got an open look from deep, let it go. I mean, you've got to play freely and with confidence.
And that's just great work there to get in the shooter's space and then go and corral that backboard.
Here's Williams. The 18-footer is right on the mark. And now just a 5-point Rocket lead. Houston's gone 2 of 4 from 3-point range so far in the second quarter. Beverly dishes to Monte Ennis. It's rebounded by Dallas. Nowitzki's got his 5th rebound right now in the game.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
And the shot is good. That's 12 points for Chandler Parsons.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going in this quarter. And Kevin, who says a point guard should look to pass first? I mean, not when you can finish like this fella.
Well, Clark, he wasn't going to give that opportunity up to a teammate.
Well, you know, Kevin, that's one he'll always take himself, and he should. I mean, you can't pass up that kind of opportunity or fun.
Now here's Harden. He's got 10, and he gets the bucket. And the Rockets lead by 3.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
It's Ariza on the wing. That's going to be out of bounds. The Rockets will retain possession. Harden has a wide-open look and a miss there off the inbound. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. Rockets lead by 1. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. I'm here with Coach Rick Carlisle. And, Coach, what impact is your defense having on slowing down their offense?
Well, we're active. They're missing a few shots they normally make. You know, we just got to compete. We got to keep competing the way we are.
Rick, thank you. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks so much, Doris. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back in there for the start of the third quarter after this break.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. We welcome you to the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Some struggles for Houston in the first quarter. The deficit for them at one point grew to 8 points in the period. They did not come out of their warm-ups with their A game. The second quarter went a lot better for them, and they got right back where they wanted to be before the half and now hold the 1-point lead. Kenny, what'd you think about the Rockets?
Well, the reserves really came through when they needed a spark. This is a close game. Any points you can get from your bench are huge. I thought the bench guys came in and asserted themselves like they wanted a starting spot, and that's what you want. Subs who are ready to produce the moment they step on the floor.
And looking at Dallas, Shaq, your thoughts?
I think it was their passing that's kept them in the game. You can see it in their assist numbers. They were very, very unselfish. The ball moving from side to side, guys making good cuts, it's enabled them to create a lot of chances. As long as they stay on the same page and keep working together, they got a great chance to take control of this game.
And that's it for halftime, as the second half is just about to get underway. See you after the game.
Been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now.
And what a game for Ariza. 18 points, and he's added to his numbers by hitting 4 shots from the 3-point line.
And really now you can tell the defense starting to have second thoughts in terms of how they're going to play him. That's 12 points from long range.
So on the floor for Houston. Everly and Harden, they're the backcourt. Beasley out there with Trevor Ariza. And it's Howard in at the 5 down low. Can't get it to go. Good D by Matthews. The Mavericks leading. Beasley with the rebound. Beasley's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
Wes Matthews, a hard-nosed player on the wing. Strong frame, and he really does put it to good use at both ends.
And it's Beverly missing.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Nowitzki kicks to Parsons. Looks for Nowitzki, gets it to him. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. Speaking of Matthews' strength, he really gets into you defensively.
Yeah, he wants to make you feel him. I mean, physical. And offensively, he likes to post up and back down weaker, smaller defenders. I mean, you give him that mismatch, he will attack it with vigor.
That one misses, so he goes 1-for-2.
And Dirk Nowitzki last season, I felt like the first time we saw real signs of wear and tear from all the years of him playing. His field goal percentage, points per game, rebounds, all off his career averages. And that said, though, he's still a crafty, dangerous guy to have to go up against.
Julia, good.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle at their offensive end.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Going back to Nowitzki, his value at this point of his career cannot be measured by stats alone.
Exactly, and that's what wasn't there last year, that great team of guys around him, because that's really when he's at his very best. He can still fill it up fast, and he's one of the smartest players in the league, too.
Here's Beverly after Dirk Nowitzki's bucket. Beverly, the pass to Howard. Beats it. That's good. And so Howard with the assist. Howard's got three assists in the game. The Mavericks have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Parsons dishes to Pachulia. And it's sent back by Howard. And Parsons kicks to Nowitzki. And it's good. Nowitzki's got 21 in the game.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Here's Harden on the wing. And a little luck that time, but it drops.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
And Matthews kicks to Nowitzki. Back to Matthews. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Harden. J.J. Barea's checked in for Matthews.
J.J. Barea.
Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Barea, the pass to Nowitzki. On its way from Parsons for two. He scores a 6 bucket from the floor with that one. He's shot the ball 11 times. Rockets trail by 4. Now a timeout called by Houston. One thing that can be said for Dirk is that he has been incredible in terms of an ambassador for the game. We know he's a Hall of Fame player, but what he's done off the floor and just everything for the European player coming into this league has been groundbreaking.
And Kevin, for me, he was an inspiration. I mean, he really opened the doors for a lot of European players to come over, and not just come over, but to be impactful. As you mentioned, he's going to be a first ballot Hall of Famer, and that really has set the stage for this infusion of making our game truly global. I mean, even from over here, you could see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials. And, you know, you think about Dirk's impact. Certainly the NBA saw more and more European players come over after Dirk. He wasn't the first Euro, but he certainly has been perhaps the most popular.
Barea, no good. Houston's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. And it's slammed in by Ariza.
Some hang time on that rim puts a little whipped cream on that angel food cake there.
It's a tight ball game, and those displays of strength, Clark, can get one team rolling.
Agreed.
And also the other on its heels. Let's see how this one turns out.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down. And one thing that should be noted with Dirk and his opening up of things with Europe, we now see a lot of American players go to Europe to play, to develop skills, and so on. Both leagues benefit greatly from the impact of Dirk Nowitzki.
Here's Gelglock. It's deflected, out of bounds. Dallas takes possession.
Dallas ball.
Monta Ellis is checked in for Trevor Ariza. The Mavericks have gone a solid 6 of 11 when shooting here in the third quarter. Parsons outside. Back to Williams. Unloads. Drops one in from the wing. Williams has got 16 points. Rockets trail by 4. Harden outside. To the middle. Here's Howard, and he jams it with authority.
I'm not sure how I like this one. He used the rim to get some true hang time there.
Now, he just wanted to make sure the landing was softer than the takeoff.
Okay, that was just
I'll buy that for now.
A good old-fashioned chin check right there.
And that one's good.
I like the way they're working the ball inside, because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots, and typically good things happen.
To the inside.
Look at that. Now, this is why the breakaway rim was invented, for plays just like that.
Well, he almost brought the whole thing down, Clark, by hanging on that long.
Yeah, he did.
I tell you what, though, great dunk, and this is even a better game we got going on right now.
Oh, that was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Kia. And that one's good.
He is setting this place on fire, fellas. His shooting has been off the charts.
In the corner, Harden. Parsons with the rebound.
And not a night he's going to want to remember, just not really able to score the basketball.
Some of the great passing small forwards in the NBA on your screen right now. These are the assist leaders at that position in the past month. Chandler Parsons is second.
And these are some of the best teammates you're ever going to want. Very unselfish players at a position where you don't see a lot of offensive facilitating.
Yeah, you know, these guys are really more than capable of going it alone if the situation calls for it, but they much prefer to have everybody involved in the offense, and they go out of their way to try to make that happen.
For Houston, they've gone 7-13 in the third quarter so far, just above 50%. And stolen by Parsons. Pachulia dishes to Barea. Williams, that's for 2, gets to the corner and buries it. Williams has got 21. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Mavericks.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
And also, I've been extremely impressed with their interior D. Their rim protection has been as good as it gets.
Now, Parsons, James Harden missing on the 3. Parsons outside to the left wing. 5 to shoot. And that one's good. Barea's got 9.
And really, how about the quick release on that triple there? Because he's given up a lot of height in that matchup.
Right on target you are, Greg. I mean, the quick release is what made the difference there. Any hesitation? And that shot is being blocked.
Mavericks leading by 4. To the inside. The basket is good off the assist from Williams. 11 points in the game.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Yeah, and that's important, because this game may ultimately come down to which team controls the paint in crunch time.
This quarter has brought out the best in them, fellas. Even though they're still trailing, he's been impossible to contain.
And the Rockets have lost out on some free agent wars the past few years. They have remained competitive, but you wonder what could have been if they landed or kept some of those big names.
Harden kicks to Beasley. They get it back.
That's just tremendous. You'd love to see a smaller player who can mix it up inside and handle himself in the paint area.
Barea, and it's sent back by Howard. Rockets trail by 4. Pass to Harden. It's deflected. Dallas has gotten a success rate of just over 50% from 3-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting, and he gets it to go. Powell's got 4 points now in the quarter.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Well, once they recognized the advantage they had inside, it made a lot of sense just to continue to attack that area.
Tries from 16, and another basket for Dallas. And so here is Houston, 8-point game. They host the Kings after this game. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
He has been fantastic this quarter, guys. It's just the kind of effort they need if they're going to continue to trim the lead.
Now here's Williams. He's got 21. Gets that one through the hole, making now 7-13 in this game.
I've really appreciated their activity in the post today. I mean, their movement down low has been great.
Oh, that's right on the money. They've generated a lot of easy opportunities on the inside. And you know what? He's shaking off the cold shooting performance from the first half.
Mavericks leading by 6. On the wing, Williams takes a 3. Adeyunis grabs the miss. Houston's gone 2 of 5 with the 3-point shot since coming out of the break. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the 3-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
And the Mavericks will go for a different look here. Dirk Nowitzki, he's checked in for Powell. Matthews comes in for Chandler Parsons. Raymond Felton, he's checked in for Deron Williams. And it's Chalmers in for J.J. Barea. Nowitzki's shot's good.
From that in-between range, they've been the much better team.
Well, when you knock down jumpers like that, it opens everything else up as well.
Now, here's Beverly. 9 points in the game so far. Here's Capella. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. Dirk Nowitzki picks up that one. Rockets have shot 10 of 11 at the line. Nice work so far for them. It's no secret, Clark, what this Houston Rockets team wants to do. They want to get to the line, drive the lane, and hurt you from outside the arc.
And they'll do it all at a very fast pace. I mean, they're fun to watch. The pace is something that I think sneaks up on teams sometimes, Kevin.
Good point. Felton goes in, and Matthews with the basket on the assist by Felton. Felton's got his 5th assist in this one. Rockets trail by 7. Tipped away. Matthews with the steal to the middle. Finish off the break. Chalmers has got his 1st bucket of the night.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
And Greg, you know nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
Now, here is Harden. He has 29. Jones drives in, kicks it out to Harden. Launches a 3. It falls for basket number 9 from the field. He's taken 14 shots to get there.
And no doubt the Rockets were one of the faster-paced teams in the league last year. When you have the firepower they do, you want it to become a scoring fest.
Here's Pachulia. He's got 6.
Good. The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy dude. Very, very well done. A lot of the wins for the Rockets, guys, I thought last year came from just wearing down their opponent. I mean, you can keep up with their pace for a quarter, maybe 2, but it's very hard to sustain it for 48 minutes, shot for shot.
Jones, no one around him. Second chance shot, can't hit. Nice D from Nowitzki. Dallas leading by 8. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Stolen by Harden. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Reza passes to Harden, and it's Beverly missing.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, Greg, making every shot a hard one, even the shots in close.
As the lead continues to grow, this is just heady, sound basketball.
You know, whatever they chopped it up about during the break, it's worked. I mean, they've really been excellent in their execution since halftime.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
And it's on its way from Chalmers for 2. And as we end the 3rd quarter, a great game. Both teams playing well. Mavericks ahead. They lead by 8. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the 4th quarter gets underway.
Hey.
The fourth quarter just moments away now as we welcome you back. Rockets trail by eight. Chalmers is out there with Felton. Then there's Pachulia. Then there's Nowitzki. And it's Matthews in at the three. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. It's Harden with the drive. And that's collected by Nowitzki. Nowitzki's got rebound number eight here tonight in the game. A three from Matthews. And it's Matthews again missing. And for Houston, they're shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. Ariza with the bucket.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition to attack when it's there, because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
Deflects the pass. It's stolen by Jones. And here we go. Fast break.
Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
I'm startled that he would even try something like that at this stage of the game.
A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. Harden outside. The 17-footer. Here's Jones, and he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep.
Yeah, and one reason why. I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that.
Pachulia. And that comes off the assist by Raymond Felton. And the Mavericks lead by six.
And since halftime, he has been a different player.
Beverly against Chalmers. All sorts of time. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Great game for him. Double-double now. 11 points and 16 assists. Felton dishes to Pachulia. Back to Felton. Pass to Matthews. Dallas moving the ball around. Chalmers' shot is no good. Rockets trail by four. In the corner, Harden. From about 16, again, the miss by Jones. Mavericks have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Right wing, Felton inside the three-point line, drops one in from the wing. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Harden outside. And Pachulia pulls it down. Pachulia's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. To the wing right side. The 19-foot shot. It's rebounded by Houston. Ariza's got his third rebound on the night. Jones against Felton. Jones, no luck.
He's always going to have a difficult time finishing when the defense is in his face like that.
And Matthews gets it to go.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Over in the corner, Beverly. There's the three. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Beverly's got 5 points now this quarter.
This guy will really make you pay if you leave him enough room outside.
Now here's Pachulia, defended by Jones. Pachulia, good. Pachulia's got 10 points here in the second half.
Wow, has he flipped the switch at halftime? Much more effective here in the second half.
No coverage that time. That's 36 points for James Harden.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Here's Pachulia, stolen by Beverly. And now Jones running the floor all by himself. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
And for Terrence Jones, there's a quiet excitement surrounding him in personnel circles. Last season, he was a much better rim protector, way up in blocks, and his three-point percentage
was up as well. So those are the kinds of year three improvements that talent evaluators are always looking for, especially when you come into the league as an underclassman.
Now Harden. The pass to Beverly. He's looking for Howard and finds him. He scores his fifth field goal. He's taken nine shots to get those five.
Loose D here. Critical stretch. I mean, you better off sending him to the free throw lines than to have him get that good a look.
On its way from Parsons for two. No good. Good D by Ariza. Inside. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut down to just 2 points on the bucket from James Harden.
Big time bucket there, and you can expect to see him stay very involved the rest of the way.
Now here's Matthews. Barea kicks to Parsons. Nowitzki outside. It's tipped, stolen by Harden, and it's the Rockets on the break. Harden's got the ball. The score now all even. Harden's got 9 points in the quarter.
Just a good, solid, aggressive finish there on the break.
Not going to get much easier than that, Greg. Simple.
Here's Parsons. It's good. That's 8 baskets for him now. 8 for 15 shooting.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question. I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth. I mean, full throttle ahead.
Now here's Parsons. Following the miss by Trevor Ariza. Matthews passes to Parsons. And Barea has it in the corner. That one falls through. It's his sixth make from the floor this game. Now 6 for 10.
Pretty, pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Feeds to Jones. A shot by Ariza. Mavericks with the rebound. They've led by as much as 10. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Washington, where they'll face the Wizards. And that'll be the first of a two-game road trip for them. Back to Matthews. Fires from the corner. It's hauled in by Beverly. Rockets trail by 4. Harden gets to Ariza, and he slams that one down.
Pretty, pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
The Mavericks have gone 8-13 from the field since the start of the fourth, sinking the majority of their shots. Barea dishes to Nowitzki. Good, it's Barea who picks up the assist. Barea's got his assist totals piling up. 11 now for him. And it's Ariza in the corner. All sorts of time. And it's Houston with another. Dallas has gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. Right side Matthews. Stolen by Harden. They push it up 4-on-3. Here's Jones. Count the bucket coming off a perfectly placed assist. It's all knotted up.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
And really something that the defense has to address.
Here's Barea. Great D that time from Howard. Houston's gone 2 for 2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Ariza goes in.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high, fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice, nice way there, guys, to finish up that possession.
And here's Matthews, the three, and he gets it to go. Matthews has got 9 points now in just the second half. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Yeah, and actually still too close to call. I mean, this one is tight.
Instant classic, fellas. This one could come right down to the last shot.
And he gets it to go. 33 points for Ariza.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
And really, there is no resistance defensively right now. It is just far too easy. You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
Out of bounds, Dallas takes possession.
You always want a player to have his head up and to be surveying the court, but not if that's going to be the result.
And the Rockets making a change here. Beasley's checked in. Doubled by Howard. Barea, the pass to Pachulia. Nowitzki outside. Left side Parsons. Fires the three. It's hauled in by Beverly. Beverly's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's Harden. Pachulia with the steal. Matthews into the lane. Parsons goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
And Kevin, maybe the play of the game right there.
A tremendous instinct grade to come up with a steal and then attack the basket.
Game changer right there, guys. An unbelievable play to make it this stage of a really tight ball game.
And so it's Houston with it. The Mavericks making the shot. And Beverly kicks to Harden. That one wide left. Dallas leading by three. Parsons with it. Dishes to Pachulia. Harden against Parsons. Just five on the clock. That's a two for Matthews. No good. So Houston will take it the other way. That's good from Howard on the assist by Beverly. 14 points for Dwight Howard.
It's really been a tale of two halves, guys. A slow start, but this quarter, he has really been the man.
It's Matthews on the wing. He feeds it to Pachulia. Cans the 12-footer.
That's a huge basket. Just taking advantage of the size mismatch and able to drain that mid-range jump shot. Really good basketball.
One of the stories here, Wesley Matthews getting it done today.
He's really taking it to him inside. They got to find a way to slow him down.
Now a timeout called by Houston. They're down by three. 1:46 left in the fourth quarter. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hey, Kevin. Well, the Rockets coach had some advice for the team over that last break. He's looking for whatever they have left in the tank. He said, I know it's been a hard-fought game, but now's not the time to leave anything in reserve. If you're tired, come out. Otherwise, I expect you to be going all out, full speed. Guys?
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Now a timeout called by Houston. They trail by one. 1:36 left in the fourth quarter. 1:31 left in the fourth. They get it back.
And doesn't he just have a nose, a knack for the basketball? He is by far their best rebound.
Well, he has been today, no doubt about that. His effort's been unbelievable. Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Yeah, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
A reason to watch. Mavericks leading by three. Here's Parsons. Finish off the break. Parsons got 24 points. Houston's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Harden with room to shoot. And good, he nails it.
He is just self-willing his team right now, doing everything he can to keep them alive.
Right side Matthews pulls up on the wing. Nails it.
Locked and loaded tonight. Whenever he's got any kind of a decent look, he's knocked it down.
Well, sans his lights-out shooting, they'd be staring at a huge deficit.
Here is Harden after Wesley Matthews' score. Back to Harden. It's in! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three. There's 38 seconds left to play here in the fourth. We can probably expect to see him slow it down now.
Yeah, you got the lead. Burn some clock here.
Smart move.
Yep.
To the left side wing. Nowitzki a screen. He dishes it to Parsons. Pulls up. Parsons can't get that one to fall. Now a timeout called by Houston. They're down by three. We've got 13 seconds left in the game. Guys, your thoughts?
And you know what? You've got a couple options here. You can take the three to tie it or get the quick two and then a foul.
And you know, if it opens up for them inside, the quick two, would be the way I would lean, Greg, but the foul has to come immediately after that.
And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet. And they go to the intentional foul.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Yeah, they have to extend the game. I mean, plain and simple. Use every second you can on the clock here.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And the second of two is good. That gives them a four-point cushion. So it's a narrow victory for the Mavericks, pulling out the W. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but Clark, a win nonetheless.
Yeah, and it appeared to me as though the fans gave them the emotional boost they needed down the stretch, Kevin. This crowd was not going to let this one slip away.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Dirk, during that second half, what brought the conviction the team showed that allowed you guys to win this thing?
I think we just battled, and that was good for us. I thought that really won us the game down the stretch. We scrambled for each other. We rotated. Got a couple lucky bounces down the stretch, and that always helped.
Dirk, thank you. Kevin, it all starts with that competitive spirit.
Doris, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And now time to go to Ernie Johnson, who's alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, along with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Let's quickly move forward now to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Dirk Nowitzki. He had no problem getting back into a shooting rhythm to start the second half, nailing all four of his first four field goals. And Shaq, I can tell you want to say something. Your comments?
Man, this guy's been doing this his whole career. Man, we're talking about a Hall of Famer here, an icon in the city he brought a championship to. Not forget, one of the greatest shooters in NBA history.
I can't imagine a player having a better night from the field than he had tonight. His shooting percentage was off the charts. He used every trick in the book to get those high percentage shots. He shot from every direction, and there was a little bit of luck here and there, but he was on fire.
And that wraps things up, folks. Thanks for joining us. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Harlan, and the rest of the 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. Good night, everybody.